Thank you, Chris. Welcome to this March 13th, 2017, 5 p.m. Meeting of the Select Board. This is a working budget meeting. So the only thing that we would like to do is open the warrant for the annual town meeting on April 24th, 2017, in case we have power outage or something on Wednesday. We want to make sure we're doing that.
Do you need a motion?
Yes.
I make a motion to open the warrant for the annual town meeting on April 24th, 2017.
I'll second the motion.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. We will be closing the warrant on our March 22nd, 2017 meeting.
Yeah, I think what I'll have you do is announce that you're closing it, but we can actually close it on that Friday, so.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, okay. I see what you're saying. We have to close it a month before our meeting, so we will vote to close it on March 24th at our March 22nd meeting. I just wanted to make sure that we opened it tonight, just in case. We have two personnel board end dates that we need to correct. Karen Morrill's personnel board term ends March 9th, 2019. It's a two-year term. Nancy Schwartz's personnel board ends March 9th, 2020, a three-year term. So therefore, we are staggering. I make that motion.
Second.
All those in favor?
Me. Yeah, is there any discussion?
No.
Okay, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Thank you for correcting that.
Thank
Wendy?
You. Bruce St. Peter's for catching us on that.
We would like to appoint Rachel Blaine from the Planning Board to the CPC.
Actually, she's a Select Board appointment. The Planning, Roger Sadowski is the actual Planning Board appointee.
Oh, okay.
So she is your appointee.
Okay. We overlooked that. In July. I apologize for that. So the term is July 1st, 2016 to June 30th, 2017. I make that motion to correct.
Second.
My oversight. Okay. If there's no further discussion, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. We have to sign the contract for an assessor's cardiographic mapping.
Do we have to?
I
don't like that outfit at all.
I could do it, but I...
They're horrible people.
I know you've had problems with them in the past.
Yes, I have.
Is there anybody else that does it?
Well, they cost me $12,000 for their errors.
What?
I don't
is,
believe
is there
that
anybody
there's,
else?
I think it's sort of a semi-monopoly.
Is that right?
Yeah. I mean, it's like Patriot. When you know our
what
Patriot
is the contract?
Does his
yeah.
services. Wendy, yeah. You have the contract. Do you want to discuss it at all?
No.
May I review it?
It was handed to me today, and I thought, well, we'll get it done.
Okay.
Can I review it?
Just yes. It's actually, I think
can
it's...
Can I look at it real quick?
It's a small
sure,
contract.
Yeah, go ahead first, Kip.
Sure. And while you're at it, since
me.
These are the appointment letters, if you'd like to...
Yeah, why don't we sign this? Okay. Jeff, are you here for anything in particular?
No, just listening.
Okay.
Trying to make sure I'm caught up with everything
All right.
as best I can be.
Well, actually, we're just going to try to catch up with you because we haven't had much chance to do this stuff.
Right.
And I was worried with the snow that we might not. So that's why we're having this meeting.
Yeah, we meet Wednesday.
Being capital or
capital and then the select board and
finance. Yeah,
I think finance is meeting. Aren't they meeting Thursday? Okay.
Well, they were supposed to meet tomorrow.
Right.
And we were going to meet earlier, and then if there was any discussions, we were going to meet with them, and then continue on Wednesday. But I had seen the predictions of the snowstorm last week, so just. For protection, I decided we would post this tonight, and it panned out, so it was a good thing. Kip, we can hold this. We could probably hold
this.
Well,
I was just reading their guarantee, and they say they guaranteed not to make any mistakes, but I know personally they made a huge one.
Would you like to look at that? We can do it on Wednesday. Wendy just got it today.
It's $2,425, and I understand the scope of the work, and that even if I was to spend time to see if there was somebody else that could do it, I don't think it could be done for much less money.
Right.
And since we already use this, it seems like it would be a big pain in the butt to be just a stumbling to block
okay.
to do this. So
I have I'll to say it's I have to say it's like Patriots.
Yeah.
You know, there is like another company, but it's like not even competitive, and yes. they do most of us, most okay. of the towns.
That's all
right. Well, why don't you look at it? I don't want to make you guys feel uncomfortable.
No. Just curious to know.
Thank you both, by the way, for coming today.
Oh, you're
I
welcome.
Appreciate it.
No problem.
It's all signed?
All signed.
Thank you.
I hate to drive in the snow. The mosquito meeting is still on, but...
Tomorrow?
Wednesday.
Oh. You'll go.
No, I probably won't.
I'm good enough. That's fine.
Okay. Do you want to make a motion to approve this one?
I make a motion to approve Chair to sign the contract for the assessors with CAI Associates Cartographic for mapping services. I assume it's for 2017.
2018. Map. I think all of us signed this, though, don't we, Wendy?
They put room in for everybody to sign
okay.
it. So.
Okay.
I think in some towns probably the assessors sign it, but I think we changed it around. That's why they gave it to
I'll second that. All those in favor?
Mm-hmm. Aye.
Aye.
Aye. That way you don't have to do it.
Two is enough. Yeah.
Next item on the agenda is the town administrator's report.
You want to do that?
Yeah, do you want to just talk about the compensation plan, town meeting, anything else?
Yeah, just general. Well, town meeting, you opened the warrant. As I said, I'll have it for you to announce closure of the warrant. Do you all know exactly what that entails, or should I do a little explanation of that?
Sure.
I will say something, because the opening of the warrant is a message to the community that the warrant is now open to receive articles or resolutions for the warrant. And once it's closed, we can still work internally on it, but it's basically closed to general public kinds of things. So
now's the time.
The bylaws prescribe when that can be done. We've got to clean up our bylaws, and I've been talking mm-hmm. with some folks about having a bylaws committee, by the way.
I agree with that.
It really needs to be done, because there are some things that hang us up. As someone who tries to go by the letter of the law,
sure.
and the letter of the bylaw, I think it would be a good idea to do that. So meanwhile, following that, we're going to follow that schedule. And annual town meetings on the 24th, which is Monday night, correct, as always. And I'm starting to gather items, yeah.
Did you, in case it's a two-night one, did you just verify we have a second night?
I believe I said that when I met with the administrator,
okay.
the superintendent, but I can
I just want you to check
ensure that, yep.
I mean, we've been hopeful that we can do it in one night, but just in case.
Right. Well, we do have the items that from the fall town meeting that didn't happen, so hopefully it won't be too long. I did have a question, but I can't remember it right now. So that's it, and we need, you know, the short order to put things in order here.
Mm-hmm.
What else? The compensation plan, we talked about it a bit last week. We're still working on it. I had a meeting today with sort of key people, a couple department heads, and the accountant and I went through it all on Saturday to look at the salaries and to try to put
yes.
people in to try to create equity. And we've got some challenges, so we're trying to work that out a bit more. Which leads me to my next comment, which has to do with the personnel board, I'm calling it personnel board select board hearing. The bylaw does require, I mentioned this at your last meeting, that under the personnel bylaws, part of our bylaws, it requires a hearing when there's changes to personnel bylaws. We don't have a policy, we have bylaws, so it's got to be, it's a much more involved process, including town meeting vote. And one of the things that, besides the compensation plan, which we want to present, and this is a meeting hearing specifically for town employees.
Right.
They'll be notified in their paychecks of this hearing and what will be discussed and what's for comment. One will be the compensation plan. The other will be the personnel board has proposed, and we brought this to you, a longevity.
Mm-hmm.
It would be a bylaw, not just part of the compensation plan. And an overtime, a change in the overtime bylaw. So I'm hoping that will work for the board to be there as well on...
What date is that?
It's the 27th at 5 p.m.
Of March?
Yeah, it's a Monday.
Now, I hope you guys...
Yes,
can be there.
I do have that.
Okay.
I do have that. The 30th, for some reason, that was another thing I couldn't make.
Right.
I can't make that. I mean, I was hoping to go to that.
What
was it?
That's the CPA.
CPA. No, I mean, it's at 7, right? CPA's at 7?
Correct. Has been.
I can try. I've got
the
family
personal
night
board
at 6,
is at 5.
So I don't know if I can get
no.
over it.
No,
if I can shoot
I, well, this is
okay,
the problem.
Okay, can we stick with this,
yep.
The 27th right now?
I'm good with that.
Okay.
I'm good with that as well.
And so I'll be in New Hampshire, so I really appreciate you guys.
Sure.
Covering that, because it is actually an important meeting up there. I'm trying to make
sure. You won't go.
No, I would be up there early.
Oh, where's the CPA meeting? Where do they hold that?
Here.
Here.
They've been meeting in that room, although with the extra people, we may need to meet
come
elsewhere.
Okay,
so
now,
we'll figure that out.
On the 30th, I am back in town. I can come to that CPA meeting if...
Okay.
Because you need to go to your family night.
I'll be at the family night, but if I can shoot over, I don't know how long that'll be. If I can get over after, I will.
Our primary focus at that meeting is going to be they just want more details.
They asked me, they called and asked whether I could have ask the board to be at that meeting to answer questions. They weren't specific about it. But
yeah.
Maybe we could sort this out because the FERCOG is doing this climate change meeting that night, and that actually it sounds like it's kind of important to have someone go.
Climate change?
I'll go. I think it's important that you come.
Okay.
To the CPA.
So would you go? So you would go to the FERCOG one? The main thing is just to get information.
Don't worry about it. The climate's not going anywhere.
It's going to change. It won't matter if we're there or not, right?
We'll work something
right.
out.
Matter of fact, they'll slow down. If you drive there, you're just going to add to the problem.
I'm already practically up there, so it's not bad for me. No. So, no, listen. This
could
is
you
kind
divide
of
your time? What
it
time does
serious.
That meeting start?
Like
if you could just be here for a half hour or...
I forget what time that meeting is, the climate change one.
I'll see. Did you email me? I think you emailed me. Or I think you emailed me.
I sent an email out because I was
see.
Kind of concerned. Well, what it is, I mean, I'm on top of things, so it's not like we don't really know what to do. And that's why it's important that I go to that meeting in New Hampshire, because the main thing that we're going to do in New Hampshire is that I'm trying to get all the other five states, the six of us, the six New England states, are going to put in to say that change the eligibility from not governmental to non-federal governmental units are not eligible, because we have money, but we can't spend the money, and it's driving me crazy. You have to turn over the property, the control of the property for the duration of the project to a nonprofit like Franklin. This is to use NRCS money for restoration work along the river, and the problem is there's a cap of $420,000, so you have to go out and hustle your nonprofits. And you know, we got Trout Unlimited, we have Franklin Land Trust has a nonprofit entity, and I mean, you have all these things you can do, but it's, you have to jump through all these extra hoops. So this is why this is the thing I want the New England states to, in the new farm bill, to change the eligibility for these NRCS programs, other than the emergency watershed protection money. Emergency watershed protection money we can get as a municipality, but we can't get some of the other stuff. So
I'm trying to find the date, the time, 6 to 8 on March 30th. That's the climate change adaptation training.
6 to 8. It's 6 to 8. We'll sort this out.
And just leave at 7:30.
Okay. We'll sort this out. Okay. As long as you...
I'll be there.
We'll organize this and we'll get this sorted out. Okay. We'll figure out the agenda. We should post both meetings, though, Wendy. Okay. So there's no conflict. So if Kip and I show up, or Trevor shows up, or whatever, we're all covered.
Okay. Got it.
For both those meetings. Okay. Thank you. Now we could... was there anything else you wanted to talk about, Wendy, before we went into the budgets?
No, I'm just... Yeah. Budget. We need to get into the budgets.
Okay. I just thought it would be really effective to go through this really fast.
Please.
Item by item. If you didn't have any, just because
yeah,
we haven't had
it. Item
a,
by item. Let's
this
do
is
it.
What we were supposed to do down in
right.
Boston.
We didn't have it.
And we just didn't have anything.
Okay.
So the idea is just to go over it as a first flush because, number one, we haven't have all the compensation numbers plugged in yet. And number two, we haven't met with the finance committee to find out how everything meshes together. In other words, we haven't sorted out what the, you know, the total budget is.
Mm-hmm.
So if we just go over this each line
sure.
item.
Start.
Where are you in?
I was just going to start.
Section 3. Where do you not want to, that's where the general
Section
government
3.
Is.
I've got the moderator.
Yeah, we can go to that one. Okay. I just,
so
maybe
you
I,
so
I have.
So you will see Finance Committee.
Two and three are missing from mine.
Has reviewed most of these. You will see that their recommendation on there.
Do you have a town office maintenance, town office building maintenance? That's a 100 number. I wanted to make sure Kip was okay with
let
that.
Let me try and figure out where these are supposed to go. I've got them all starting in three
I know
for some
I was
reason.
Talking about that.
Oh, no, that's
today.
Fine. That's fine. That's general government. I just
town office building maintenance. Yep, I do have that.
Okay.
You want the number, Kip? Do you all have these? This is your index?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Yep.
Do you have one? I can loan you this one. It's a little out of date, but it's a good reference for now. I mean, it's...
You have the big numbers and the little ones. It's hard for me. I would rather go... I mean, it's easier.
So it's 192.5430. You're talking building maintenance or... Building maintenance?
Building office.
Town office building maintenance.
192.5400.
5400.
So it's in there. Three, beyond your three tab there.
Yep.
It's what?
It's
tab three.
Yeah, that's where I'm at.
It's called town office building maintenance.
5400. No. Yeah, there's a mistake here.
5400.
Oh, no, that's right. Okay.
The only thing that's really new on this is the sewer. We included some for sewer.
Carolyn?
What?
Down in your right-hand corner, what's the date that you have on yours?
I have 222.
Mine's 222.
Okay. There may have been some changes, and it may be still being worked on.
Okay, why don't we just share?
Do you know
I just
what
want
happened?
You to look at
okay.
this.
Okay.
There is an amount for sewer. Do we actually have a
$1,000?
Yep.
Okay.
Do we have actually know what the custodial services are going to be, Wendy?
I don't believe there's going to be any change.
Okay.
He's here, we can ask.
I know, I was just thinking.
Put him on the spot.
In effect, I just want to tell you something came up the other day. I was just talking with him. Cleaning the windows once a year is included in the contract, so that was discussed the other day about the windows.
Okay.
He says he does it after they sweep the streets.
Yep.
All right.
He does it in the spring usually, I think.
Which one are you looking at now?
It's not. The only thing that's high is the electricity, but I don't know if this is, why did it go up so much from last year? Because our rate actually went down.
I think this was put together before we had switched from the Hampshire COG. Mm-hmm. This was based on the Hampshire COG budget versus our new contract.
Well, if...
So you think we could safely put it down?
When we met this morning, we were talking about comp plan, but Kevin had this in his hand, and I saw some writing on it, so it may be changing. And I also noted that I don't know about this building, but we will be having the, you know, the reduction from the solar installation. So
last year it was 16.5.
Right.
So,
and do you recall what he said about this? Did he talk? He's coming to the finance committee on Thursday night. So
yeah, so $800. If last year was 16.5 and we had enough money, it's going to be at least $800 less. And that doesn't take into account our credits from the solar. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so well, that was why I wanted you to look at it.
I think if we 16.5,
if we lower that down to 16, you could lower that $3,000.
Well, rather than change it per se, we'll just flag it. What I wanted to do tonight was flag
it.
Because this is we're going to meet with the finance committee.
Okay.
So this was a flag. This would be a flagged item.
Okay.
I don't think we can talk about select board staff salaries because unless those numbers are solid.
Is that your next one?
Where are we now? Yeah. What number is that?
I'm so confused from you.
A few back.
Oh well, I'm mine aren't necessarily good. But there's not a number on here, that's probably why it's stuck after the building.
We did do that sheet on, did I give you that copy?
I have a 2/21 dated copy.
You know what, it's in your folders.
Oh.
All right.
That's okay. Do you want me to, I can go get them.
I got it. I've got 2/3.
Yeah, I stuck yours in your book and theirs.
2/3.
No, this is a 2/21.
Selectman salaries?
No, not selectman salaries, staff salaries.
Oh, staff salaries.
Oh, well, don't worry about it.
I don't have any of them.
All right.
That's okay. Here.
So this is, oh, boy.
50, 45.
This is the...
One to be filled.
One to be filled, right?
Yeah.
This is the one that's being, it's already.
I thought we did it.
Passed.
Oh, I've got it right here. And it is in your book. You've got it, Trevor?
This was, I don't have
311?
No, none of
I
us
put
have.
Them in your mail folder. Sorry.
Okay. No, that's my fault. I didn't update it.
Let me go get it.
I thought I put it in your book, Trevor. Because it was there.
What you have to do, just to give you a heads up. If you go to replace one, make sure you pull out the other one.
I have. I've done a
hold it over and get rid of it.
Pretty good job of that, but I think some of them I haven't gotten.
Because what happens is you get confused. Thankfully, most everyone puts dates on their stuff.
Right.
But
so any of these has dated.
Was it in? Oh, I looked at that on the way in too.
Did you find it?
No.
I put it in your book.
These are the two that went in my book today. Old.
So maybe we didn't. Maybe she waited. Okay.
Oh, no. That's fine. So is there
let's skip over that.
Oh, I don't have one. Oh. Well, never mind. So the police payroll is
going by this date here, so we can ditch anything that's
older than that.
Okay.
Yeah. Yes.
All right.
So this is let me ditch this. Did you get the new police one?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's the top of my list.
Now,
well,
this
really
is slightly less.
We skipped the other so far? The staff salaries?
Yeah. Yeah, because I guess it's...
Not ready?
Not ready. So this is wrong. This is a new one.
And then you're on police payroll?
Yeah, and then... But well, let's not do police yet. Let's do accountants. Making you go back.
I was hoping at least to do the select board ones, so...
Yes. Well,
and
so I don't have any issues.
I have one, so I don't know why you don't, but maybe we just decided to...
Have any in section 5.
Okay. Brenda and I were going to, you know,
study it. Do you have
the
updated 311?
I need your book, Skip.
No, the staff, the select board?
No.
All right.
I thought he did.
So I ripped it out, thinking that we did have, going to get one.
No, we don't have our education ones in here yet either.
I have one, and I thought I had that for you, but I could make copies and give it to the
group. This is what we have so far. It's been fixed.
You have selectmen salaries. Expense, legal expense, and contracted, well, these are the ones to talk about.
Because we're going to be, because we didn't add for this one last year.
Well, because we underspent the executive assistant one. It's been empty since last year.
Right.
And Wendy's was mostly empty.
Okay.
This is...
Here. This is old, but...
No, I'm giving you the new one.
Oh, you're going to get a new one. Okay. All right, then let's go to the accountant. Did anybody have a problem with the accountant that
no,
we just got?
I talked to Wendy, and she said that that was gone over and discussed, and
okay,
that's good.
Yep, that's fine.
All right.
That's the accountant's salary, right?
Yeah.
And then, and we don't need to do expense.
No. Well, we
that's
we
finance committee. Are the ones that we need to do in highlighted in yellow, is that the idea? Or not?
Well, we should look at the whole thing.
Right.
Here.
Thank you.
Should start with looking at those under your purview. So that would be your salaries, the one I just passed out, with the office salaries,
sure,
the expense, legal expense, and still in the works, but we can have a conversation about contracted services.
Okay. So this is the updated one.
Yep.
Do you have that? Okay. Are you all set?
Do you want me to explain it?
Yes.
You can go over it if you want.
The executive administrator, executive assistant position is the top one. That amount is a placekeeper. It's not
hoping.
Necessarily the amount. And
that
it is actually beyond the amount that the personnel board is recommending advertising, and but with the caveat if we can't find somebody to go back to them. So this is
a place
having
over.
Something in there. Not a whole lot more, but something. The administrative assistant is the position in there, and that these take into account the rates and hours that we're looking at with the new compensation plan.
So okay. Is that what they're currently getting?
2017 is what they got.
Yeah,
correct.
2000.
But
yeah.
The hourly rate is for the new compensation rate.
Yeah, okay. It says proposed in
yep.
Rate. Okay. And then mine and Brenda broke that out into two, because my anniversary date is during the fiscal year, not July 1st. My contract is
January.
January. So.
Okay. Good.
So
That's fine, because the increase is just because we're actually going to have, be fully staff. So that's all right.
Okay.
We can talk about that.
Trevor, will you make calls that for me?
Sure.
Contracted service, what's the number for contracted services?
Contracted services is 159-5410.
5410, yeah.
We spent a lot of time on that one. And we're still working on it. Because that includes a lot of I don't even have it here. I think I had mine out because I was working on it.
Oh, look at this. This was a 131, and that had 20. So they did bring it down.
Where? What section is that in?
Yes. I thought I saw 19 on what? For electricity?
Yeah.
On what I saw in his hand today.
I'm sensing I don't have a lot of these sheets in my book.
Me either.
Are they in the wrong place?
No.
All of those should have been. Okay, you know what? Contracted service, it isn't, let's not go there just because it isn't done yet. Yeah, that's the one. We're still trying to, there are some other programs we're looking at. We need a couple of new computers in that office. I don't know, we'll go under here. It'll come before, it may go before capital planning.
I'm going to come in and make a whole.
So legal expense, let's look at that.
What number is that?
That's the next page, 5300, 151-5300.
What are we looking for again?
Legal expense.
Mine is the 3rd of February.
Yeah, yes, and this is already, as you can see from the bottom, it's been approved by the Finance Committee.
Mine doesn't.
Oh, sorry, no, it doesn't.
Did you approve it? Did you approve the legal expense?
I don't have the budget with me, so I don't know.
Yes, you have, because I wrote it in on mine. 2/14/17, I wrote it in on mine.
Yeah, I don't have it.
Because I was at your meeting when we did that. In fact.
I don't know how you feel, but I do want to keep it low. I mean, you know, we seem to have a pretty good relationship with our legal counsel. So if we have something that turns up that we need extra money, then I would rather come to you for reserve transfer than to just have money sitting there. Okay?
That's fine.
Okay.
I just to tell you what I did, you can see there's more allocations here, so we can really keep track of, because I've been going through the bills every time we get the bills and assigning what, and I'm seeing that, you know, there were none associated, but we had a number of things, a lot of things related to planning, zoning, that. So I just,
inspection.
I separated that out more so we can really attribute it to where those legal costs are. Okay? So
yep,
that's the main change. It's small. I'm trying to think, where is it up? You'd have to really parse through it because I did
ZBA
do that.
ZBA is up. Yeah, ZBA is up a bit, and then you had the planning board and the...
But general admin, yep. I brought down, and I separated out, so you'd have to really see where that is. Police department, down, because the contract was negotiated. Mm-hmm. We looked at, we went through all the, the current account to see where the bills came from,
mm-hmm.
And what to anticipate for the rest of the year, so...
I'm comfortable with this.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I would rather keep it low.
Yeah.
And like I said, if there was something occurs unforeseen, then we'll just ask for a transfer.
I bumped up
legal expense.
Now, the only thing there is ultimately, or over the long run, if we can come up with a reasonable estimate of what we're going to spend, then that's what we should do.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if we put $20,000 into it, knowing full well that we're going to spend $25,000, that makes no sense.
Right.
Well, that's why we bumped it up last year to $23,000.
Yeah.
Because it seems like that was more realistic. Remember what happened is a few years back we eliminated the standing charge for Bud Pepin.
Yeah.
And that have the budget in half.
We don't have, as far as we know, we don't have any. The police contract isn't up.
Right.
So we don't have that.
Oh, dear.
One thing that's missing for me that would help me a lot doing this is that we have last year's figure, but I don't know what we spent. You know, so even though it says we're going from 23,000 to 23,700, did we in fact spend 26 this year, or did we spend 18?
If you look at the last 4 years, we definitely overspent what we budgeted.
Yeah. You see total expended?
Okay. We have 39.
So it just wasn't...
Yeah, just last year, 2017 isn't done.
Thus far.
Everyone before is at least 10,000 over.
If you go to the expenditure line item, you can see, you know, the report here.
Okay.
You can see what we actually spent.
All right.
And we get the monthly report from Brenda. So, and that gives you an actual expense too.
All right.
So you can track it.
So did we just ask for a transfer in these cases or shift from another?
Yeah. What happens is if we go over the budget, we go to the finance committee so that they have legitimate. I mean, we ask them for transfer.
Try very hard not to go over it, but I have to say, in all my experience, all the towns I've been in, they always budget too low for any
of those. I know. But
but I'm hopeful that we won't. We would not have here.
I know. But I.
Well, I mean, if you do look back over history, we've gone over by at least 30% every year.
Right.
Yeah, but we've had. It's been for specific
and
reasons.
And this year is going to be, well, I know. And this year we had the ZBA, that issue with the ZBA, so that's going to add to it. I think that was $2,800. So.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. If you want to. I like being conservative because that tries to make us stay on line, but I don't know.
I don't know. I'm not familiar enough with the process. Is it a big deal to go and ask for the money? Is there money available for them?
No, because that's what you do the reserve for.
Okay.
But it really has been one-off stuff. It hasn't been like any specific reason to overspend.
There's some things that are wrong. This doesn't make sense. Look at 2013. We actually saved money, but it looks like we deficit.
Yeah.
So that's calculation is not right.
Well,
and then we don't show 2015.
Right.
So,
or 2016.
Those are not reliable. I don't know what happened there because it's all.
Well,
she's got a calculation. There's a calculation right in
this,
there.
This year is the one that we eliminated to our other law firm. It truly, most of the time, it is one-off, and it is stuff that's just popped up. I mean, we can talk about it, but that's what the reserve transfer is for.
Yeah, I guess
it's for where we had expenditures that we could not anticipate. So
well,
you can anticipate.
No, but that's the thing. These are things that popped up over the course of the year.
Well, if you're talking about legal expenses, and you think we're going to spend $30,000 next year that you should budget for. Fight it out that way.
It has been fairly.
It's been
fairly consistent around 30-ish.
Yeah.
I just threw that out. I'm not suggesting you do that, but I mean, if you know that 23 is just not going.
Well, it's been 30 for the last 5 years.
True.
And we've got. We know that we're going to be dealing with more legal things to dealing with Oxford coming up. Whether we go through with this transaction with the bakery or someone else, there's going to be things
there. Did you get anything back from the governor's?
I did hear that they're still wanting to go forward.
And do we hear from the governor's office?
No, I communicate with Steve Kulik. He's checking into it.
Okay. Maybe we can
find out. Oh, this was yesterday.
We'll give him a little time.
Well, we'll give them Monday. We'll find out tomorrow.
So they're still interested.
Okay, good.
Okay.
Well, we just have to get that stupid thing signed off on.
So do you want to increase it?
Want to change it to 30?
I do.
It's fine 30. With me.
Okay.
Because all we would end up doing
it,
is coming to you.
We go back to free cash, right?
So yep. If we don't spend it, it does go back to the free cash. So is that okay with you guys?
I don't have a problem. If you want to increase that, I mean, if you really don't think it's possible to do for 23, then we shouldn't be budgeting
right.
23.
Well, I don't know.
So split the difference or something like
that.
Well,
if it's split the difference. do 27 or something.
Do you want to do that? Well, let's temporarily go up to 30.
No.
Okay. And then let's see when we get together on the big picture.
Yeah,
we can
see where we're at.
Crawl it back down.
No, I...
Given the fact that tomorrow night we're not meeting,
right?
Can we postpone that joint meeting with all of us until after we get a chance on Thursday to
Well, the only thing is, I think it's going to take us more than one night.
And well, I think so too.
Because we're just starting. I mean, we haven't really had much to discuss, and we're hoping to skip the compensation thing together. So we could just, I think it's important just to be together and not make any, we don't necessarily have to make any decisions, but I think we need to get a picture. I want to get a picture before Thursday, okay, basically.
You won't even have a picture until after Thursday.
You don't think so?
No, not until we've had a chance to look at those, not until we've really had a chance to look at all of those
salary
budgets that make up the omnibus budget part. And there's a number of them that are sitting just waiting for the compensation package. Otherwise, I mean, we've gone over them, but I'd like to total that up. We get a total on that. We know what the, at least we have a fairly good idea, I think, what the capital items are. I'm not sure, haven't really looked at to see what's out there for any other articles besides the capital budget. Hmm. But, once we get that, we've got a pretty good handle on mm-hmm. where we stand. Then we can compare that with what we pretty much know we're going to have for revenues and see where they...
Where it shakes
out. That's the big picture.
Okay.
We need to get to.
All right. It's okay with me.
When do you think we'd want to get together?
After, assuming you... Or have you taken a look at the budgets that have salaries in to see what changes?
No, that was why we were hoping to get to do that on Wednesday with you. Because we haven't looked at it yet. I mean,
Thursday. Yeah, I heard from Brenda, and she asked whether she needed to come in tonight. And I said, well, you're not meeting tomorrow, so Wednesday, it's done with the class, she could come in and finish up the salary, months with salaries. She had to leave Saturday. But
she won't have it done so that we can have it at 5 o'clock or 6 o'clock.
She might. Oh, she might. She did a few already, so. Thing is, we're going to, have to take a look at it again, as you know, so.
Well,
there might be changes after the hearing.
So what would you like to do then? Do you want to meet?
I prefer to do it next week if you can.
Next Tuesday? Oh.
Or next Wednesday, it doesn't matter.
Well, next Wednesday is our regular selectmen's meeting, so we might actually have,
mm-hmm.
we've kind of, why don't, Trevor, can you meet the 21st?
Sure, I've got it already in here.
Actually, I had already the 21st on my calendar, so.
Mm-hmm.
At
7.
How about you? At 7? And,
the 21st?
Yeah.
And I also have the 22nd.
Did you get
I'm just figuring now what budgets we're going to be meeting.
I just found it on my desk today.
I've already got
the budget.
I'm sorry.
I just figured with the budget coming around, there's a lot
it's
of meetings
gone up
to happen.
20%.
So I've got them all plugged off.
That's a couple people. That's
okay,
all.
So
that,
so why don't we cancel? Yeah.
The numbers are increased.
All right. Then how about Kip? I'm going to call John Parsky and Paresky and see if we can cancel the capital improvement too, because then we don't have to meet on Wednesday. We'll try to do capital improvement on the 22nd.
We're not going to have a selectmen's meeting on the 22nd?
No, on the 15th.
Haven't you guys finished the capital budget yet?
Oh, yes. No, this was for the church.
Oh, okay.
So let me see if I can get John to reschedule for the 22nd, because I wanted
right,
to make
so
sure we had the...
This Wednesday night, just reschedule it before
yeah.
the select board's meeting on the
yes.
22nd.
Yes. Jeff, can you make it on the 22nd?
Yeah, definitely. I'll be.
Okay, well, let me, I'll see if John wouldn't mind reposting, because we don't really, aren't ready for Wednesday anyway.
Okay, so 5:30 on the 22nd.
Instead of 15.
Yeah, if it's okay with John. Well, I'll see if, because he sent me an email today, and I said, well, as far as I know, we're still going to have it, but I would think I would want to repost that for the 22nd. And then we will have a joint meeting on the 21st, then,
right,
with you.
You'll have to discuss that.
See if they can hear that.
Everybody's at home.
Yeah. Sorry, Chris.
All right. Thank you, Chris. Sorry.
Yeah, so. What do you want to do for Tuesday? At what time do you want to do on the 21st?
You pick the time.
6:30.
Yeah. Is that okay?
Mm-hmm. And how long does the Capital Improvement Committee meeting?
That we're going to do that a different night.
We're going to do that on the 22nd.
Okay.
At 5:30.
So I've got the finance on the 21st at 7?
Yes. Oh, no, 6:30. We just did 6:30. I'm sorry.
All right. I cannot be here that night.
Okay. That's okay.
Sorry.
Okay.
Yep. Hello.
I'm sorry to interrupt. The Historic Commission?
Oh, in that room.
Right in that room, 1:30.
So we're going to meet on with the Finance Committee on the 21st at 6:30 instead of the 15th. And I will call John when I go home.
Okay, I have it in the minutes.
And see if we can reschedule. So that will give us another week to work on the church.
Okay.
And that way we will have a final number for the 21st, maybe two, on the church for you all.
Is the Select Board going to meet this Wednesday night or no?
Yes.
No.
No,
we're going to cancel.
The 15th.
Because that's only going to meet with them.
If they don't have anything ready till after Thursday, it's not worth. Give you another week. Give us another week.
Okay. I can go out and shop and work on my mosquito trap.
I can tell you how to build them.
The Finance Committee is meeting.
I'm making one ultraviolet ray.
You're meeting.
We'll put it on YouTube.
What's that?
You're meeting Thursday.
The only thing is it's solar powered.
There's no meeting tomorrow night. And she's going to try to move CPs. I mean, Wednesday.
Lithium batteries.
If I improve the panels, moonlight would work.
With the lithium battery, they may just blow up and kill the mosquito.
Yeah, so.
You meet at 6:30? You meet at Finance Committee meets.
6:30.
Okay. It's very confusing.
I know. Well, it's okay because it makes sense.
My phone's getting hot.
I know. It makes sense not to meet on Wednesday then if we don't have final numbers.
I would really like to say, here's the capital, here's the omnibus budget article. Here's basically the capital improvement article. Those are the two big pieces that make up the budget. And here's the revenue items. And let's take a look at where we stand.
Yep. Well, it makes sense that we have more opportunity to get that together.
And then, you know, the other articles, we haven't talked with, what's the other group?
School?
Well, we don't have a final number for SCIMS yet. It's the same number as last year, only better. We just haven't gotten the only better part done yet.
It's almost like changing the healthcare system, only better.
Well, no. Ours is
14 million less people?
Yeah.
It's going to be cheaper.
Maybe not, though. Okay. Well, how do you want to go this? Do you want to just go through these?
Yes, okay. But I wish they were in order.
All right, well, it doesn't.
I'm all over the place.
Oh, hold on.
And I wish I had them all.
Well, I have, my next one is the personnel board expense. Do you have that?
Personnel board expense?
Yep.
Hey,
okay.
Look at that.
152,5400.
154.
Two. 152,5400.
Personnel. We're in the hole.
Yeah.
No, no, that's a positive. They spent nothing.
Oh.
Mine doesn't have.
They didn't?
They didn't. So we gave them 250, but they didn't spend it. So it went back into free cash. So they're just.
So we're just giving them another 250. Why do we, do they spend it ever? They haven't spent it in the last 2 years.
Well, that's true.
I've been putting a membership of the.
They've never spent it.
Personnel Association under our budget. But I share that information with them and let them know. But that would allow them to go if someone wants to go.
I think what we can do when we go over with the finance committee, when we're getting down to the numbers, we can just say if a board has never spent any money, then let's eliminate it and then have them, if they have an expense, they can go to the finance committee.
Right.
Okay.
Makes sense to me. I mean, you never use it.
Work that out.
We will, probably. But I don't want to.
Town clerk expense?
Why problem? Why can't we just?
All right. We'll just say recommend.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Conservation Commission?
No, I got town clerk expense.
Okay.
I'll move it, but.
No, that's all right.
Conservation Commission?
Conservation Commission.
They're.
They have overspent for postings and stuff. Do you think 800 is enough, Wendy?
What are we in?
They can go to the finance committee if 800 is not enough.
Well, plus we absorb these things into our.
But how does this work? Is it like the planning board, when applicants come in, they pay a fee to the conservation commission, that money goes in the general fund, and then we appropriate the money this way? And on the planning board, it doesn't quite work that way because they have their own fund.
I know.
Does the conservation commission have a fund too?
I don't think so. Because they don't usually have all that much activity. In the past, they haven't. But they've had to post stuff.
Did they spend any money? Have I got a different sheet?
They've spent. This is what they've spent for mailings and, you know, postage.
And they were budgeted 500, though, right?
Yeah.
And they spent 487.
Yep.
And they budgeted 800. They've spent nothing.
This year looks like. I mean, they've already spent quite a bit.
They have?
Well, they've had activities.
But where
they've
do you
had,
see it?
Well, it's not here, but.
Oh, but you know from.
It was like Cumberland Farms. They had stuff. So you have to advertise. You have to do postage.
Mm-hmm.
You know, notifications and stuff. You have to mail out letters.
So you can leave that at 800.
Butters.
Yeah.
All right.
Yep.
Okay. Open Space Committee.
So I'm going to write on this that you approved it.
Again, they haven't spent any money.
Do you want to vote?
Yeah. Well, we'll just vote at the end.
Okay.
Again, they haven't spent any money.
If you're keeping tags on this. Open Space Committee, they haven't spent anything.
Same with the Planning Board.
Okay, so we're just going to wipe that.
Yep.
All right. Planning Board, Kip, what do you recommend on this?
Well, they haven't spent. Well, 2016, they only spent $186. Is that right?
Part of the reason that figure is low is because of the fees that we charge.
Right.
And I've asked John a couple of times, but I don't understand who controls that money. From what I understand is that when there's an expense to the planning board, Brenda pays it out of, I don't know if you want to call it a reserve account or whatever account that the planning
revolving
board.
Revolving account.
A revolving account. So
they requested $1,500 less than last year, right? To bring it down to 6,000.
Yeah.
Did you?
The only thing that I can say is that the assessment that we pay through the FRCOG for Pat Smith's work comes out of our assessment that the town pays, whatever that is. We do pay Pat Smith for additional services, but that is always covered by either the application fee or through the applicant's fee themselves. So I think that's sufficient.
Okay.
All right. So You comfortable with 6,000?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
6,000?
6,000 for planning.
We're comfortable with 6,000.
How about being comfortable with one, if we ask him for one?
For what?
For $1?
$1,000.
Oh, $1,000.
Yeah, since they really haven't spent it.
Well,
and they're sitting with I don't know what the revolving fund is.
Yeah, but I don't think we can legitimately pay Pat out of the revolving fund, can we? The revolving fund is for her services for evaluation. I think it was the way it was set up.
But that's what I just asked you. Pat Smith's general services come out of the fund, the amount, the assessment the town pays it for COG anyways. And she gets...
No,
we've always paid.
A separate contract.
You pay separate for her?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay.
I
thought it came out of the total assessment.
No.
All right. No. Then I don't know.
No, we've always paid separate for her. But she does a lot of your minutes and does some general research.
And there are things that she does.
Oh, we're talking about different. I'm talking about Pat Smith from the FCAT.
Yes.
She doesn't do our minutes.
Oh, she doesn't do minutes? But
no.
I thought she does.
Pat Kroll might do it afterwards. But.
Oh, okay. Well, maybe then I missed. But she charges stuff every time she shows up at the meeting, right?
It depends on what she's doing. If she comes as a peer reviewer, she's paid by the applicant.
Right.
If she's doing things for the planning board, she gets the...
That's what we pay for.
Right, that's right. What I'm saying, the
so
town's assessment.
$1,000 is not enough.
No,
it's a separate contract.
It's a separate contract. She's always charging extra. So when she shows up, that's why I thought she was doing your clerical stuff.
No.
Because our bills are separate. We get separate bills every planning board meeting from her. That's what this $5,000 is.
Do you have the report with you?
You know, Carolyn, I'm going to have to talk to John about that because I know a lot of the bills we do get, but they're paid out of that revolving fund, or they should be, because that's what we do with that money. When people come in for site plan review, they pay $250 plus $10 for every 100 square feet of disturbed area. And, you know, just...
Well, when I was signing off on the bills, I know I signed off on bills that was just like general work for the planning board.
We actually
have... That's different than the $7,500 because we paid out $80 so far out of that.
Well, I actually just got an email from her earlier this week saying they hadn't received payment on a few bills, and I said, where were they sent? And they got behind where they were sent different places, so I'm following up on those. So we do have a few bills that will be paid.
That will be coming out of that,
and,
okay.
Only the peer review gets paid out of the fees.
Well, I do know that
so.
At our meetings, John Waite signs this warrant for her to be paid. But
that is what the town pays for.
All right, I will find out.
Okay. Well, then let's skip this for now. Although I think 6,000 is probably okay.
If we don't have a lot of activity, I mean, she also.
What do we get for the assessment? Which is $43,000
a year. That's 46,000 or
yeah.
Something.
Wow.
Enough. I'm wondering.
That's why I just thought it was part of that.
No,
assessment.
No, I can tell you it's not.
All right.
That's just being part
it's
of
not.
The
It's not. We pay for that. Not all. The assessment goes to all the communities who are members of FERCOG.
Right.
And
do we use that off? How much of it?
$43,000.
I think so. I mean, I think we get.
What do we get?
You got training.
Well, and now that we bring. Now, I don't want to get
climate
too disreal.
Well, that's in here, I believe.
A climate change meeting I'm going to go to.
While I'm thinking of it, what about the nurse thing? Do you still want to go through with having our paramedics do that? And we have to give her a year's notice? It's a long time.
Have you gone to any of the meetings to discuss anything alternative with them?
No.
Okay. Well, we can. You have to give
But if it's an expense, I mean, we could have the EMTs do it for nothing.
Do what?
I think it's more important that we try to hammer down on the overtime and get them into the building. But I'm, we have to give them notice by June for a year. So we need to discuss that.
We give them notice in June, and that's for all of 18? So it wouldn't matter if we give them notice now or then?
Right.
No, and so we need to sort out, we have to go to the Board of Oversight and discuss. I mean, I can't imagine that ultimately people are going to be not wanting to do that, because that was what we envisioned, was well-being checks, blood pressure clinics, all that kind of stuff. But the nurse is really important, because somebody has to be responsible for handling Maven. And
just a infectious disease reporting
case,
system.
That's why we got the nurse to begin with. It's because we had two TB cases. And you are responsible for making sure that person has those shots. And, you know, it's a huge responsibility for us as Board of Health to take that on. So if we do cancel this, we need to make sure that we have some way of covering it. And we should talk to the Board of Oversight. And I mean, to me, it's logical that we would have a part-time nurse through the EMS, and that they would somebody would take on the Maven responsibilities. But somebody has to check that 24/7. You have to, because that's when your follow-up diseases
are. That's when we get the emails.
And I know, I mean, I'm on it. I have, you know, the password, but neither one of you are there. And so
I have it, but I'm not following it every day.
Yeah, and so if like one of us is out of town and something shows up, we've got a you're legally responsible for following up on that disease if something comes in.
How would I know that somebody has the disease?
Because you're supposed to be checking Maven every single day.
And that's what the nurse does.
And you have a little alert comes in on your phone, and you're supposed to like log in and go on.
Well, the alert, I guess my wife told me I'm late for something.
Well, I'm just saying that there are ramifications of canceling out.
All right.
I don't have ultimately, I'm okay with it, because this is what we envisioned when we did South County.
Okay.
All this extra stuff was supposed to be, we were enhancing all the services to our community. But before we do that, there is a transition period.
You've got
to
get lined up.
And we need to work all this out with Sunderland and Waitley, too.
Sure.
I mean, we can't just say, you're going to do
this. This is what you're going to do. Right.
Yeah.
Right.
So I'm sure they're going to be interested, because they do not have, I mean, they do have people that are supposed to be doing it, but it is a huge responsibility.
Yeah.
And it's a legal responsibility. So
back to Skip's question about the $1,000, they've got plenty of money in the reserve fund to cover them a year or more. I mean, I don't know what they pay in it, but there's $20,000 in there.
Yeah, but that's been paid by peer review people to use towards peer review expenses. I don't think
Does
it always
get billed
up?
It can only be used
up
for that kind of thing.
Yeah, you can't use it for general.
You're talking about revolving fund?
Yeah.
Yes. You can't use it for general stuff.
It's got limitations.
But isn't that what we pay her for, the review and stuff?
Yes.
For specific projects, but not for general kinds of, let's say we want to change zoning or take a look at something.
If someone calls her up and asks her a question, and she does research, you can't do that.
Well, but we charge the solar people $3,500 for site plan review. That had nothing to do with peer review. That was just the fee, and that goes into that revolving fund. So we can't use that?
If you had hired Pat which you did, to do the peer review on that, or to look in to do research. She did something on it, because I would happen to be in her office when she was fussing about that.
So what do they pay that?
I was doing the debris management template up there in her office when that came up.
So that revolving fund is to be paid out to her or anybody else that's
doing
stuff for the planning board?
Related to that particular project.
Right.
That's why you charge for that particular project. Ultimately, there's going to be money left over, and then you can transfer it to the general fund.
So that could get transferred to the general
there
fund,
actually
or
was
a portion of that could get transferred to the general fund.
There's been a change from the Municipal Modernization Act around revolving funds.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to go into detail about it now.
Right.
It's a little complicated, but it may be not subject necessarily to, I know you'll be happy about this, town meeting approval. But we'll talk about it when we go over warrant articles.
Well, there were before we get together again, funds. I'll talk with John Waite, and if I need to, I'll talk with Brenda and Pat Smith and find out exactly how
find
that
out
is.
If that's enough and what, well, and if we can cut it back.
Yep.
Okay.
All right.
Because she might in fact only be doing a few hundred dollars worth of extra work outside of any kind of peer review stuff.
She does a lot of stuff.
We have a board that's very, very dependent on her services.
Dependent.
So I think we need to engage
the only thing we do on
all
is
them.
Breathe.
So, you know, we have to keep that in mind.
Okay.
So you should have this in your budget, which explains this for
yep.
COG budget. So
yes.
You can look, read through it.
Where
you
is
know.
That?
It's at the beginning of the book.
We all have in different places because it's really not obvious where it is via the appendix. So I have it. Yeah, I have it
I think
at the
I
end of the
third match up
third
my book
tab.
With somebody who's got everything. Mine is missing a ton of stuff.
Well, don't worry about
assessors.
It.
I don't have it.
Don't worry about it. We'll sort that out. So the planning board one,
mm-hmm.
we're going to hold, Wendy. That's not one that we're going to approve tonight, okay?
I have that planning board on hold.
The zoning board of appeals is $1,000. That's been adequate, pretty
mm-hmm.
much. They've been spending, although last year was over $1,000. Hmm. And this year is going to be relatively high, too, because of the... They've been having a lot of activity.
Yeah.
So maybe $1,000 isn't quite enough.
No, I think
the Finance
good.
Committee recommended 471,
that?
Right?
Yeah, I think we did, didn't we?
Who?
And it's one of those things where they need $500 or more. That's what you get. That is where I think the small things
right.
you can do in reserve fund quickly.
Right.
You know,
so you went with 471. How did you come up with 471?
I didn't.
It says...
That's what the paper says.
That's
what the paper says is right. 471 is what you recommended.
That's what
they
were given.
They were requested 1,000.
Someone had to change that.
Amount.
If it says 471, it's because it got changed, right?
Okay.
Yeah, we didn't cut it.
All right. So you didn't cut it?
No, it's...
I don't know. We cut that.
So
I think it was a request for 471. That's the number we saw. I remember that just kind of...
It is kind of funny because here it says, you know, Finance Committee recommended 471, but then it says Finance Committee dollar change 471. So I think somebody just didn't fill this out right.
Okay.
So we'll go with $1,000.
Okay. All these things, what happens is when we meet with the Finance Committee, all these things get adjusted based on if we have...
So what are we doing? Is this like an exercise?
Yeah, well, it's just if you have any questions or
and it's just a review. It's just, yeah.
Okay.
Agricultural Commission, I think we recommended zero, and we're going to do zero again.
Okay.
Yeah, I think
okay.
we put 100 into that, didn't we?
Yep.
Yep.
Yeah, you did.
Yeah.
But you still want 100?
It's like that. Yeah.
Okay.
It just keeps it open.
All right. Well, the...
I don't know that they've met in the last couple of years, have they?
Yes. No, they've met.
Okay.
And they're going to be meeting again because we're going to do the noise cannon on our agenda in April, the first week in April. We're going to send out a letter and hopefully meet with them prior to our meeting.
So we're going to recommend 100 anyways.
All right. Yep.
Okay. Got that.
Now... This is an older town office maintenance.
Right.
So this is on hold because the rendition that we had before was not correct.
Okay. Town office expense.
And what it was, Wendy, the reason why it was on hold is because of electricity.
Electricity. Yep, we did that first
okay,
thing.
Okay, you're talking about right. building maintenance versus...
Yep.
Yes.
Okay.
Town office expense... You, did you do town office expense?
I thought we had, but I don't have.
Yeah, I have it down that you did it on the 14th.
Yeah.
And what, did they approve the 18,700? Okay. Did you guys have any questions on that?
It's down.
It is down.
Right.
Why is the phone bill so high?
I think it covers all the buildings, right?
Yeah. But we go, we were supposed to have, did someone check to see if that contract, if they were actually coming and giving us advice? There was some kind of.
I got rid of it. That's why it's $9,000, not $10,000.
Okay, thank you. And then, but were we going to look at some alternatives?
For what?
For the phone system.
Tin cans and a wire.
Smoke signals.
I have not heard that discussion. It's actually an old phone system, but it services pretty well. I've heard no complaints.
But the $9,000 must be for a carrier charge like AT&T or whoever we.
Right.
Yeah.
Who do
no,
we deal
is.
With?
Right. It is. I don't know who it is.
Verizon or something?
I think it's Verizon.
It is Verizon. Verizon. Okay. Well, all right. If the Finance Committee's approved it, let's just let it go. And then maybe sometime during the year we can look at competitively trying to bid out.
A question just on the reports, because they were 7,000, 6,000, now 35, and now we're down at 20.
That's because Pat did it last year, or I don't know how often, and just brought it to Staples rather than goes through the
big printing
company that does most of the town reports in the state.
Is that what we're going to do again?
And it came out very,
nice, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Sounded good. Yeah. I mean,
okay.
The product's fine.
Good.
We got to see if we can put that on the website.
It's supposed to be on the website.
Everything should be on the website.
Everything should be on the website.
We're working towards it.
We have to print them out, is the question.
Yes.
I think we do.
We do. People would have a fit if we did.
We can
sell them for a buck.
We should look at the amount we print for that reason.
Yeah,
yes.
If you put it on the website.
There's a huge stack over there, so.
Just print fewer of them.
That's what I just said.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, we should look at the amount we print for that reason, but we should put them on.
We have to print them some out, but we can definitely cut down on the numbers, I think. Just because people are truly not really interested.
Although some things like this, you pay the same amount if you do 300 or you do 500, or you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So
and that's why
if we don't need them, why print the extra? But
right.
We'll look at that.
It's general insurance. You want to?
Wendy, are we going to get a discount because you went to that cyber security thing?
This year would be for this year. We just got small rebates on two of the policies, like $1,900 and $1,800 on another. I got that today. And Barbara's preference, one is workers' comp, was that we get a check rather than a credit.
Right.
But that's your decision, I think, or,
well,
you know,
Kevin,
I have no problem with that.
Kevin did some safety things.
Yep.
That was going to be a credit. And
and I offered to host something here. That should give us free insurance, right?
Yeah.
So
well, it should give us a discount. It should give us a discount. I think it's just, we just have to keep looking at all these little discount things. And did you approve the general insurance, you guys?
They did on the 14th.
Okay.
Yep. I
have that.
I don't know what that little one is.
Recommend is probably the better word.
Yeah.
Recommend.
Well, that's all we're doing is just going through this until we see what everything shakes out, and then we look at see if we have to cut anything. Clerk, treasurer, collector, salaries. Is that what you have that?
Let's see.
So that's when that goes next. You know?
Well,
let me give this to you. It has my name on it, but I have an extra copy. This is the FERCOG stuff.
Clerk, treasurer, collector, salaries.
This is for
FERCOG. You said you didn't have this.
Okay. You didn't have what the assessment covers.
Okay.
This went down a little bit because of training.
Now, Wendy, mine is 214, so that wouldn't have the comp.
I'm sorry, which one are you looking at now?
The clerk, treasurer, collector
salaries. That doesn't have. Would that have? Mine is dated 214.
So they have got the update. It's not up yet.
Oh, yeah, salaries don't, we're not.
Not doing those, okay.
Yeah, we're working on that.
Then let's do the expense. Is Barbara certified?
Expect to include 3,000.
Is that why, I mean, she doesn't have, go any certification, is that why it's the?
Which, I'm sorry, is this town clerk expense, or?
Yeah, town clerk expense, is that why that's down?
Binding, no, which one?
No, I guess it's her.
Elections.
Tax taking, she doesn't.
Oh.
She doesn't have to worry about that as much this year.
She never does.
Okay.
You've got excellent taxpayers in this town. But what is down, as you can see, is elections, dramatically.
Oh, you know what, you're looking at town clerk expense.
Yeah, I just asked if that's.
Oh, I'm sorry, it was treasurer collector expense, is what I was looking at first.
Right, that's what I have.
All right.
Because we weren't going to look at salaries.
Yeah.
That's down good?
So that's okay?
Yeah, it's the.
The GAS.
It's the accounting system.
GAS B 45.
So.
It's down, oh no, yeah, there's none of that this year.
I don't think I have that.
And unknown is apparently known.
Okay. All right, town clerk expense, the elections, that's down.
Sorry.
That would be down.
There are no elections next year.
Yeah, so that's less.
Did this include?
Yeah, she's reviewed it.
Oh, no, that was a CIPC thing, right?
The only thing I asked her to think about is whether she wanted.
The machine was on capital, right?
Some more training for her staff.
The machine, it was on the voting machine?
Yeah.
That's on capital, right?
Voting machine.
That's on capital.
That's on capital, okay.
I think you did discuss it and recommend it. I think you did discuss and recommend it, but I don't have that notated.
It's in the capital article.
No, I'm sorry, the expense budget for town.
The mileage is down.
What's the maintenance of the codes?
That's a contract with
That's our code.
The people who do our code book, our bylaws.
You know, they are supposed to update anything that we change.
It's really the elections that are way down.
Who does that? Because it's not up to date.
Yeah, which one? The one online or the one in the blue books?
The blue books.
General code. We met them. We had a long conversation with them.
Yes, we did. I got an email from them this week, too.
Yes, so.
E-code, right? You have to send in the changes. The changes have to be sent to them, and then they update.
What's missing from, some books have been updated, some have not.
I've been in Dick's office several times, you know, the last several months, looking up things that, you know, were wrong, so.
Well, if they were recent changes or, you know.
The last change would have been town meeting.
We should be looking them up online, right?
They do it once a year. It's not worth it to them to do it every time.
Online's the most current.
They do it after town meeting. Supposedly, we're supposed to send stuff to them, and then they do it once a year.
Is the street listings just the cost of printing that?
Street listing is chasing down people and the printing of the actual street lease and the mailing out of.
The forms and.
The forms, the census forms and all those things.
Okay.
But there's also staff time that is not included in here, I'm sure, because they actually chase down people that don't return. Okay. All right.
Moderators, okay, right?
What do you have?
The moderator?
Yeah. So what are we going to do next? We can't do salaries.
School.
I guess we could do Board of Health expense. That's 512. We have.
Police?
We haven't done police yet. We could do police.
Police is the next one.
Do we have?
you can do the salaries of the police with the exception of the chief.
Yeah, I have the police here.
But we can't change that anyways.
No, that's set. I have the new 311. Did you get the 311?
I have the police.
Yeah, you should all have that.
Yep.
Okay. Did you already approve that?
With the exception of the chief's salary.
Okay. Is the crossing guard on our comp schedule? I just saw that.
No.
Okay.
I don't know. Where they're under here?
Yep.
Crossing
Remember
guard?
We were trying to think of all the random stuff we have.
Right. I don't think the poll workers should be on a compensation plan. They're once, twice a year, you know, maybe. Where's the crossing guard here?
At crossing guard is at the bottom of the police payroll.
Oh, there it is. I don't. John didn't bring it up, and we were talking. He was engaged in the conversation today, so.
Okay.
I have sent him something, so I will make a note about that.
The Quinnville compensation went up so much this year?
Yep.
That's because.
That's we had the, that was
the
negotiated.
Negotiation.
You didn't have it before.
What?
You didn't have it before this
For
contract.
All of them.
No, I just wonder why the increase.
Because.
Because it's in the new contract retro to July 1st.
Yep.
Or whatever. Do you know how many hours the crossing guard works?
It's 181 times.
4 hours, maybe?
4 hours, probably.
Not quite. 3 hours, maybe.
Two in the morning. Well, maybe, yeah.
Maybe four.
Well, just the personnel board would like there to be a minimum, basically the town's minimum hourly rate for anybody, $13. That was their
okay
proposal.
Well, we'll have to figure that out. Okay. I don't know how many hours it is. Trevor just said maybe three.
I'll ask the chief because I have to send him something else. So. You have the 311 one, correct?
Yes.
They haven't discussed that one yet. And I think the big difference is the chief's salary.
Okay. Well, we haven't.
Because that's in the comp plan.
Well, let's not include this in the numbers. The police. We'll wait until we see what the finance committee.
I just already turned the page anyways.
2.3%.
Oh, okay. I think we have to look at the whole picture, and then we can look at the salaries. Police capital request.
Or department expense?
Department expense.
Department expense, that we look at? Or capital request?
So it's up
20%. Well, we have both.
Does it look, is it?
I don't have both.
So this.
Oh, you don't have both here.
It's behind other things. Okay. Would you like us to maintain your budget? Well, you're keeping your budget book.
Well,
so
these are all new, so.
Yeah.
Kip, don't worry, it's a little confusing. Here. This is, mine is dated 2/22. Yep, you got the same one. All right. Did anyone have any questions on this?
So this is, the large part was in the increase, was the Goose Town and Tri-Tech were, used to be in the contracted services budget and are now moved
are
here.
Are you now back to
This is police
expenses?
Department expense?
Not a capital. Okay. Yes, we moved it. Because it was exclusively police department.
And then they had some radio repair, which was an addition.
Well, the gas bill should go down this year because we got a new cruiser that gets over 30 miles a gallon, and I hear we're getting a motorcycle.
Two.
Who hears?
Two motorcycles?
But those are a grant.
But they still use less gas.
Yeah.
Well, not a lot.
Well, not that much less.
Well, the then...
I bet you it'll be...
But the maintenance line is going to be kind of high.
You think?
Are they all going to be using them, or just a few of the officers?
Is it a Harley?
Yeah.
Are they literally getting Harley?
Yeah.
Wow.
I think he was, the chief was talking about getting somebody, getting other people's trained. I know that Joe Michkowski's trained. He rode them over at UMass, but...
How is the insurance for them?
I have no clue.
Not for the motorcycle, for the people who ride it.
Oh.
Same.
Yeah, they don't complain.
Sure? They're going to need it.
No. That was my hesitation.
No. They can walk like me if they want. I'm just not a fan of those things.
I made my husband give up the motorcycle.
Yeah.
When he started having kids.
Yep. You need him around.
So I said, you're not.
So
not
dangerous.
Leaving me with the kids.
Nope.
So, okay. Wait. So it's up 20% over last year?
Yeah, but that's because of we've added these two that were in contractual budget. Which were in
and
our
radio
budget.
Repair.
The only thing that's really up is radio repair.
What's the new equipment?
No, it's radio repair and moving these...
The Goose Town and
Tri-Tech. Oh, you mean
software.
Radio communication system. Yes, yes, yes.
Well, there's a line item that says new equipment. It's $8,400.
Right.
I don't
maybe
know
that's what that means.
Took a look at John's...
Well, the next page shows the...
Cruiser.
Well, in my book, it shows the emergency communication system, which may be how Brenda put radio repair into the budget. I'm not really sure.
Where?
It's the FERCOG.
At what point do we have the department heads here to ask them questions like that?
Oh, no, we can, if
any times
we flag this, and then we can ask. Yeah.
Okay.
That's the purpose of doing this.
But,
in Boston, we just whip through and we say, okay, this is our questions. These ones are the ones we approve.
In December, that's when you do that.
Yeah. No, we do it in January. We always do it in January. Or we have done
we
it.
We move it up to December.
It's March.
I know. But we hadn't had...
They've been doing it. They've been doing it.
Okay.
Kip, it's my fault because there was no one here. And so we didn't have budgets. We didn't have anything until Wendy came.
Okay.
And even then...
I mean, Trevor and I didn't have anything for us to look in Boston at all. So, I mean...
Crickets.
Yeah. So
things,
you didn't miss anything that way.
So, I missed the Women's March.
Yeah.
Yes, you did.
Yes, you did.
Next year, we're going to make
we missed you, too.
okay. Next.
All right. So then I have the moderator is next. Is that section three?
It's my front one.
Moderator is the first one in there.
I know. Well, mine got in section three. I don't know why.
Yeah, mine's in section three.
It should be in section three.
First one, section three.
Okay.
Which is the first?
Which is the 100 number.
Right.
Moderator.
So you got any issues with that?
No.
Okay. Selectman salaries, no increase.
Kind of high, you know.
Watch it now.
Watch it, it's right.
We also figured...
I saw it approved.
We've got a damn full-time job, so come on.
We're going to let you guys pay the assessors out of your budget.
When they stand up at town meeting, you mean?
Are you going to bring it up?
What's that?
I don't know. I have an idea, but never mind.
Oh, I'm doing my own PI on that.
Okay. Well, I can give you... You can interrogate me.
All right. So, selectman salaries, you don't have any problems?
I didn't even get to that, but.
You went over that budget pretty quickly.
What?
Selectman salaries? I was at the meeting, and there was no, it was a unanimous vote by the Finance Committee.
To approve
it. And I thank them tremendously for it.
Listen, we put in a lot of hours this past year.
But it's not retro pay.
It is not retro pay.
Oh, it's the same pay. And you're the Board of Health as well.
Yes, well, and...
And the sewer commissioners.
That's taken up a lot of time. Okay, Select Board and administrative expense. Wendy, is this $5,500 enough for our, if we all went to the meetings, like Kip didn't go, you didn't go, you used my name tag. So I don't think we paid anything for you. If we paid for you and the three of us, is that $5,500 enough?
I think so. I looked at what's been expended, and I did some estimates. I think that is, you know, not going to we just pay for registration, rooms, and mileage. Yeah. That should be enough.
And your trainings
are in here.
Most
other trainings are free that happen for Select Board
members.
Local. There's a lot of good local trainings.
But your procurement training...
Right, and I've decided and I've got that in there.
Right.
But I'm probably not going to take the full course because it turns out I don't need to be certified.
Okay. After the course you went to for the
I feel like the overview course was enough, and that
okay.
I would like to have the new executive assistant go to the next overview course.
Okay.
And I
good.
So we'll figure that out. But I think this will work. It's still a little higher, looking at dues. I think it's good. I think it's good. It's a little higher.
Well, we spent less this year because we weren't expending money. And Kip didn't go to January.
But it still went up 14%. I don't get it.
Well, it's because of this, the dues. She's signing, this dues is went up $300.
Well,
the training
is the big expense, and that includes the CPO trainings.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For the two, for you and then the new one.
And it will be for the new one.
And, you know, I'll see, you know.
We might not have to spend that much, but I think, I just want to make sure there's enough.
All right.
Because if we don't make the town incur costs, that is a huge savings. And that's one of the reasons why that January meeting is important, is so that we get an overview of what's happening on the state level and that we can... Mm-hmm. Be as proactive as possible so we don't incur costs.
That's very beneficial.
Well, next year you should stay at the Hilton, at the Ramada at the exit before, because the room's only $69.
Is that right? Have you been there? Have you stayed?
I
see the billboard.
But the MBTA just announced today it's going to cut
really
weekend
nice,
service. So.
It was a really nice weekend, but I would have to say, a very high percentage of them is we always have a snowstorm, and we always have, I've been there when there's been no hot water, and it was pipes were freezing.
And how much are you paying?
I don't know. It's a lot. 100 and something a room. And that's a discount.
Yeah, it's a room.
It's heavily discounted.
The registration and
I feel
mileage.
Like it was discounted. It should be discounted because...
Well, I said to my wife...
You don't even have hot water.
I said to my wife, do you want to go to a trip to Boston? She said, sure. I said, no problem. I called up. I got the rates for room. I told her, I said, sorry, they're full.
Yeah, you have to do it very early.
Yeah, no, you have to sign up. We sign up in September.
Oh, you told her. Okay.
He's kidding.
You have to sign up in September to get
So where do we budget our Friday pizza parties?
Don't do that.
No? You just don't get a budget for a Friday pizza party?
No, that's a donation out of our salary.
All right.
What's that?
I can do that.
The pizza parties. I donate pizza in the past. We have had, our training nights and stuff.
Yeah.
That's why we should need a salary increase. My husband doesn't want to subsidize us anymore. Okay. That's what happens when you get close to retirement.
Yep.
Finance committee.
These are the big spenders.
I also let me just say that if you look at the notes on this for just before we move on from administrator expense, that I wrote new select board members additional trainings. So
yes.
We put some more money in there for you guys to get up to speed.
Good. I will take advantage.
Training for what?
The job.
Well, most of the parts of the job that I've been involved with, the people on the other side needed the training, not me. And we paid them a lot of money, too.
I know. I'm assuming your finance budget was...
Is he talking about me?
The finance, you voted your...
Engineering firms, I think.
You guys voted your finance budget?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, they did.
They did lower it.
Why?
We what?
Which one are you looking at?
No, it was $500, right?
Why don't they have a number?
It's $250 for a couple of years.
That's why I can't find it.
Yeah, now it's at $500, right?
Yeah. Where did you find that? Why is it... The number's fine, but I don't know why it's not in my book.
Well, here, just do this one, just look. It's okay, it will show up.
Oh, there it is, see?
I don't have it either.
Oh, it's in the front.
Oh, there it is.
How come it doesn't have a number?
No, it's not.
It did come out on some of those sheets.
Mine's a 125 number. What do you have? Yeah, you're on 125.
It's one, should be 131.
Okay, so finance committee's okay?
Yep.
Accountant, salary, we just get that sorted out. Accountant expense.
You got the accountant salary, right? I mean...
Yeah, we got the new one.
Yeah.
We got the new one.
Yep.
And so we're okay with that. Accountant expense. That is a 125.
Came down a little bit, yep.
Did you guys do the accountant expense?
Yes.
Okay.
It's fine, right?
It's a little bit less.
Yep.
A lot of this...
There's training in this year's, in the '17 budget, it's not in the '18 budget.
There is, it's a little lower though, yeah, some training, right, right.
Okay. Assessor salaries? We're gonna...
They did that already.
Okay. So we'll just keep that the same. Assessor's clerk salaries, we're gonna skip that unless, no, this is an old one, so that's not done yet. Assessor's expense. Same as last year.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a new, it's a five, there's a change, so that it's a five-year instead of a three-year recertification schedule.
So there is no recertification in there, so I don't know what's gonna happen with that.
Yeah, it's not listed, right?
It's a five-year cycle going from...
Well, yeah, but I mean, there's no money for the five-year, so...
Right. Wouldn't you wanna just...
I think it's that they simply don't know what it's gonna be.
I see.
So you may have to...
Bruce, you might know, didn't they also in that Modernization Act change the revaluations to like 10 years?
I think it's...
Three to five.
Three to five.
Three to five.
Five?
Yeah.
So that would bounce the revaluation from 9 to 15. That you'd have to have 100%. But I also believe that they're probably funding 18 out of their, what do you call it, certification account.
I don't think they, what I gathered from John, they don't really have a good handle on the expense of their salaries.
Yeah, they have substantial account, the same account that they took it off of last year.
Well, they had, yeah.
Yeah, because there's no...
When's the last recertification?
There's no account change.
Yeah, I don't see any change in what I have.
And there was nothing for 12 and 13 in this report, so...
Oh, here it is, the next page.
Yeah, the certification is in, they have zero.
So, yeah, look at that.
But wouldn't they want to budget?
So what, are they coming to you for reserve or are we just gonna wait on this?
I think they're gonna wait.
Okay.
Now, having said that, you know, tomorrow they'll be in saying, oh, we're gonna need something else, so...
Okay.
My impression was that they're gonna wait.
How long can they wait? I mean, shouldn't we put something in?
Don't we wanna put...
They don't know what the number is, so it's kinda like, okay, fine. It's gonna be a five-year deal and we've got two or three more years, then we'll just spread it over whatever the remaining years are.
Okay, all right.
Okay.
I see, okay. So
We should kind of keep that in mind, too, because that's a lot of money, and if all of a sudden you think the budget's down and say, oh, you know, this is one of those reasons.
It's going to be hanging out, yeah.
You know, Skip, I am really concerned about next year, as I told you, so even if they don't want to put anything in there, I don't want the chance that we might have, like, 20,000 next year, when we could put 10 this year and put it towards next year.
That's what I was thinking, just spread it out a little further.
You can talk about that.
Yeah.
I asked it, didn't get an answer.
Because if they come up with, if they get sometime during the year, they get some kind of estimate, at least we put aside $10,000 towards whatever that estimate is.
We can throw in another 10,000 in the reserve fund to it that way, too.
Yeah.
Well, I was going to ask you if we really try to budget as close to the bone as possible, I would feel more comfortable if you went up to 100,000 reserve fund.
Yeah, we'll have to, you know, next week. My hopes that, you know, we'll have a good handle on it.
Okay. All right. I was nervous about that last year.
I mean, the alternative is at not this year, but in future years, and we've done it before, where we go to town meeting, and you know, we have a special town meeting, and we appropriate there, money out of free cash flow. So, I mean, we've got double coverage on those items, and you've got full 2 months at the end of the year left, so.
Yeah,
By and large, no one is going to spend their budget.
Yeah, that's true. I just wanted to be sure that if we're really, truly being very careful, then one thing can just upset everything.
I mean, we've got a couple of things that we're trying to do. And putting the capital stabilization, for example.
Right.
Whenever we get to that, that's going to require a chunk of money. If we end up doing it, I assume we will. We need that money from someplace too.
And this is not a criticism of Frontier, but what made me nervous is that they're cutting down on their free cash instead of making any real cuts to their budget. I mean, they did lower the budget, but they are cutting their free cash quite low.
Notice, they took, half of their free cash, or half of E&D, whatever it is.
Well, yeah.
And they've done that before too. So long as they're not using all of it.
I would feel better if they made real cuts. But.
Well, we'll also see what their E&D looks like after this year.
Mm-hmm.
Typically, they'll have more. It's like we have free cash. Mm-hmm. Ours, we have an idea where something is coming from. Theirs is going to come from simply not spending the money.
Right.
Okay.
So what happens in a situation like that if we just say, look at whatever this number is, you know, you need to cut it by, let's just say 2%. And they say, well, you know, how are we going to do that? I say, well, you know, it's your budget. You figure it out. We're just telling you it needs to be lower.
It doesn't usually work that way.
Why?
You have to have two towns to tell them to cut.
At Frontier, you can't do it for the elementary school either. That's something that I would like to put on the agenda for the next meeting. It's what do we do when we have a budget that comes in that's that we believe is above our ability to typically.
Well, I guess I, because I'm so naive in a lot of this, is that I hear several times in communities, large communities, where they say to the schools, we don't have this much money. You have to make it work. So whether it's they lay off teachers or cut programs, or but they do it.
And but that's single town schools.
School,
like Greenfield.
They do it at regionals too, Carolyn.
But you have to have two towns at least. Right. Okay. Two towns.
No, I understand. And so you have to have the vote. But if you go back and you say, look, we don't have the money, you've got to do something with your budget. They do it.
They'll try. And yeah, they'll work.
Now, does our elementary school fit into the same thing as regional?
No.
Okay.
The elementary school is ours
so
only. So
school
we can
union 38 just administers the okay, elementary, okay.
Yeah, the Deerfield Elementary School is a town budget. So, but again, it's town meeting approved.
But you have to have two towns.
For Frontier.
Frontier.
Okay. But
otherwise, it doesn't work out. Oliver Smith, trustee, does anyone have a problem with that?
Nope.
Okay.
I think we went through them, right?
Yes. So, Wendy, are we missing any that...
Well, still working on contractual services.
Yeah.
And if you notice in the... we're trying to get back to perhaps a data... It's still called data processing. But we used to have, I believe, a sort of a... capital plan around the computers and that kind of thing.
Yes.
And the phone system might be in that as well. I'm not sure. No, I guess not. Well, it could be. At any rate, we're going to try to get back into that.
Yes.
But okay. This is, we can't do everything at once.
Right.
I am making that proclamation. Try as I might to be doing that. We have to figure out what's most critical and then think about going forward, what are our priorities for going forward and maybe next year. During this next course of this year, try to
plan forward.
Yes.
Yep.
Did you
address something?
Kip, the only other thing I can think of is the highway expense. Did you have a chance to look through here? Because I know you had some questions and some ideas.
No, we're going to talk about the building department, inspections department as well.
Oh, course. Yeah. That goes back here.
Go to the highway.
We I just want to look at Dick's.
Right off the bat, what is it with the $5,400 clothing allowance for the highway garage? I don't. I mean, I can see that they've done it, but I don't see that it's a necessary thing.
Is that their uniforms?
They don't need uniforms.
Yeah.
The highway department?
Yeah. It pays.
Really?
We've had this conversation a few times.
They wear sweatshirts, T-shirts. You know, they have safety vests. You know, if they're working the road, they have those. But
But wouldn't they be purchasing that?
It's a clothing allowance that it's not atypical. Most towns do it. Even Little Leverett does it.
I would imagine.
To pay back for their use of going through jeans and shoes.
But
your boss doesn't buy you clothes.
Yeah, I have an allowance.
They buy you clothes?
It's small. It's like $500 a year, but yeah. Because you go through it. You wear out your knees pretty quick, and especially doing that job. But
in lieu of having uniforms, which can cost you
more.
Yeah,
we pay, I don't know, 75% of it. They pay 25% or vice versa or something like that.
Can come up here?
I don't know. I just think that it's a waste. It's something I've done all my life, and you know, you wear jeans, and you know, you don't wear your best clothes all the time because you might get dirty, you know.
But they get dirty every day, right?
Yeah. Why don't we have an explanation of this? Because I don't think it's so much jeans. I think it's shoes.
Well, yeah, boots. Boots are $300.
I think it's safety shoes.
Mm-hmm.
Winter.
I think you're right.
I think it goes. I think it just kind of goes.
Bruce has a comment.
I don't know.
I'd like to comment on that. A couple things. One, I believe that that was instituted with the previous
superintendent,
and I believe that was instituted on its own. The town did not accept that statute for purchasing or leasing equipment for its employees. So I don't believe that that should even be valid. Also, if you want to do a comparison, if you look at the sewer plant, I believe that's for 8 employees, if you count the number. If you want to do a comparison with the sewer, which is 3, there's only a $525 allowance there. So it's
but are they required to have a steel-toed boot there? Do you know? But it
should be on OSHA every car.
I think we should have
complaining on safety.
Kevin
addressed
this.
Is what this is for. It's just so we'll flag that. Kip, did you have anything else? On the line items?
Oh, that was the first one.
Clothing allowance.
The electricity here, once again, it's gone up quite a bit, and I mean, I know the new building, but...
Yeah, but you know what?
No.
This is dated 2/22.
Yeah, what's the...
I don't think there's been any adjustments at all to the contract for when we signed the contract, the electricity contract, Kip. So that's a good line item. What's another one that you had? The one I had was the tree work was actually reduced, and I was concerned
that we
had cut that 1 year because of our deficit, and we haven't been able to keep up ever since. So I'm not, I wanted to flag that and say I would at least like to level fund that and not have that as a cut. Did you actually go over the highway expense yet?
We did go over the highway expense.
Did you vote it?
No.
Okay.
I don't think we did. We may have.
Actually, this is, you're right, it is uniform.
It doesn't show.
It's uniforms.
Yeah, how are your uniforms?
Well, it says from uniform company.
Mm-hmm. The other thing is, this whole thing about paying for licenses, fees, and continuing education things, the debate is we need to pay these people more money because we need to hire trained people with a license. That's why you pay more, because these people come with a license. It's part of their job requirement. I don't see that the town should pay for them to maintain their license. Do you see what I'm saying?
So you're saying it's part of the job description?
It's part of the job description, yeah. As a plumber, if you hire a plumber, he has to have a license. If he doesn't pay for his license, he's not a plumber. So therefore, he can't generate that kind of income. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, let's look at that. It's just that I know.
It's not.
We have to
the
be
difference,
consistent. We
right,
be
but
consistent.
The difference is if, like an assessor, okay, he has to take courses to learn his job specifically for the town. That's it. But a truck driver with a CDL license, that's not the case. That, you know, it's more of a universal thing. You know, he could leave here and go to work at Warner Brothers or vice versa or anything else. You know, I think things are specific to the town, and I just pulled that assessor thing out of my hat. But I can understand that type of an expense. But, you know, normal things, you know, we're paying these people extra money because they are qualified to do that.
All right. Well, let's flag that. What else?
What do we pay for beaver removal? I thought that was illegal anyways.
No.
For trapping.
For trapping.
To be trapped and to be located.
So
do we
pay somebody to do that?
Yeah.
It's contracted.
It's contracted. Our animal control officer couldn't do that? He's really good at getting all kinds of other things.
I know. He does a lot.
It's a whole different operation.
Okay. We can look into that, but believe me, $1,000 is pretty cheap for beaver removal. When we call, that's usually on a 24, it's a 24/7 kind of thing you call. And like when we had a lot of water, and we were worried about a dam being compromised, they go and trap the beavers and you can pull out a few sticks from the dam.
Is there a reason we have nothing in culverts, or is that, I mean, there's a thing there, but we haven't had anything for the last few years, and I know we're always needing to work on culverts.
I have been able to cover some of those expenses.
You know, okay. I'd like to talk to Kevin, too,
personally?
About, I've kind of went back up. We have $45,000 in vehicle maintenance. I mean, all our vehicles are pretty much brand new. I don't think we have a truck that's more.
I think we had a $20,000 vehicle expense this year, this fall. I'm not exactly sure.
Yeah.
It seems to be that. And so it's one of those things that, you know, it's a big piece of equipment. If something goes, it's expensive.
And if you don't use it, then it just rolls over.
Okay.
Yeah. It's not like, these line items stay pretty solid.
They're not like a capital expense where it gets spent.
And the
like the schools, if you, when you give them a chunk of money, they can move it around between the line items. We don't.
Well, you see over the last 3 years, the gasoline expense has gone up $5,000, but yet the cost of gasoline has gone down almost 45%, and we don't have very little gasoline engines. Every, you know, I pushed really hard to buy gasoline pickup trucks, but we have all diesel, so I don't understand why.
Is there a separate line item for diesel?
Yeah.
And the diesel cost is almost the same as the gas, and diesel's more money, but everything that we have, I mean, I think there's only, I'm going to stick it up about two pickups that are gas.
Well,
so
we can check that out. Kevin mentioned that he expected to be speaking with you, Kip, yes, about your concerns about the budget.
Okay.
So he is waiting to hear from you. He's anticipating that.
And the other thing is, there's a line item here for general highway road materials. And what was the other one here for general highway patch? And both of those amounts should come out of the Chapter 90 money that he receives for highway repairs and stuff like that. It shouldn't be in here, at least I don't think. It's $25,000.
Well, and except, I think the except town gets that he's, it. Yes, but except that I think we've been using Chapter 90 for, like, Kevin has been hiring paving contractors to do it.
I understand.
And we have been pretty much to the allotted amount.
I understand, but I think some of that money could be used.
Mm-hmm. No, it could be.
Matter of fact, I mean, I don't drive on every road in town, but I think overall we have pretty good roads in town.
Well, mm-hmm. As a matter of fact.
No.
Didn't we just have a report that we need a lot of work done? I mean, that our roads are.
Oh, that with the pavement management schedule?
Yeah.
I mean, they were not stellar. I think, yeah.
Yeah, but
I mean, I think
that just tells
roads,
you the schedule for doing things, and that's actually a little.
Well, I mean, most of our primary roads are really good, and a lot of our secondary roads are. I mean, I do know, I've been on a couple that, you know, are not the best, but they're, yeah, you know, they're not pothole ridden and stuff like that. And that Chapter 90 money, actually, some of it can be used for equipment and could be used to offset the expense of that highway garage, because they changed that rule. It's not just for building roads, it's any maintenance.
We did say we did offset it by $1 million. It wasn't $1 million?
That was stabilization.
Oh, was it?
No, I don't know.
Anyway.
But the town gets, I think, was around $300,000 to $400,000 a year? Chapter 90 money?
It's like three something.
So, you know, if we took $40,000 of that and used that, you know, for part of the heat of that building, and especially for these two items, it could come right out of that budget.
Kevin can go over it with you.
Okay.
I just want to say, just to be, I thought the clothing allowance was for personal clothes, but this is a uniform. You say they're not wearing uniforms?
I thought they were.
They have T-shirts,
then they must,
and sweatshirts.
Okay, yeah, that's.
I think they,
well, they may have more.
Right.
There might be their shirts and pants as well. I don't know.
I mean, when I worked at
the auto repair store,
they would come and they'd bring you new clothes because you get all greased. But I just assumed they did that at a highway garage, but maybe I'm wrong.
It does say that there's a 4% increase from the uniform company, so there are uniforms in there. And I'm sorry, I don't know more to have an informed conversation.
I don't think it's a good idea. I don't like the practice. I mean, today I got all greasy. I ripped a pair of expensive pants on a rusty old nail, and I mean, it just happens. You try to be careful.
But that is your business, though, right? I mean, versus somebody working for a company.
Well,
you know what I mean? It's a little different.
Most companies don't really buy uniforms. I don't know.
I thought they did.
Service-oriented companies, and they're,
if they're sending people into their houses, maybe, but I don't know.
Yeah.
Most institutions do buy uniforms. Like, I mean, that's.
I just thought that was
budgets.
Common practice, but I could be wrong. But I'd still be curious to hear what he says.
This is okay.
Yeah.
This is.
See what he says.
I mean,
and what about
this? This is what we mean.
Why is the patch like?
Now, when are we going to start buying Wendy clothes?
I don't
think we can afford that.
And the teachers.
I don't want any more clothes.
And the building. I mean, do you see? I mean, I don't.
No,
I'm
talking about things that
you
get greased up, and, you know, like the mechanics and all that stuff. You don't bring that home and throw it in your washing machine.
Right.
You have a company come and do it, right?
He does until he gets caught.
Right. His wife throws him out. anyways, I was just wondering why the patch is this year $10,000. We haven't, maybe we haven't patched for the last few, five years?
Well, we have a patch machine now that heats it up.
I see.
And I think that was why
that
it was new.
That allows us to patch now instead of...
In 2017.
I see.
You heat it up.
Yeah, and, I imagine you have to.
Because it
it's
saved
not
us...
not just cold patch, it's...
Right. It saved us a lot of money, and it's much better, actually.
And that's all true, but it still could come out of Chapter 90 money instead of in this budget.
I see.
But we can talk to Kevin about it, because you have to understand that we sort of decide what we're going to do with Chapter 90.
And he must have another budget... Yeah. That would explain where he spends the chapter.
Yeah. No. Oh, yeah. Well, we go over it.
No.
No.
No. No. You don't see it.
You.
We see it.
Yeah.
We,
okay.
We talk about it generally with.
Great.
And that's where it comes into decide where you want to put stuff, and how you want to spend it. And, I mean, a lot of it is based on complaints. If like River Road sucked up a lot of money. In that repaving.
Yeah, I mean, instead of having a budget, it's going to be here's what needs to be done.
Yep.
Right.
And here's what we anticipate the cost to be.
Yeah.
We decide that you know that's a priority, and that you know that that was well over $1 million. So that was like multiple years of Chapter 90, and we decided to do that. Mm-hmm. Yep. And so that's what comes into play. You decide.
You wait a while to build up.
Well, yeah. I mean, that was a decision to.
To
do
wait
that.
A couple of years,
and do
build
it.
Up enough, and then be able to
do the whole road.
I see.
I mean, that's part of your discussion when we go to meet with Kevin.
Sure.
So we can do that. Let's just do Dick Kalaszewski's, and then we're kind of much
ice
done.
It's just a common. We just keep that.
That's
right?
The same.
That's the same.
What
same
happens is it's.
I can see 1 year it was a way over.
Yeah.
2015, you had a bad year.
That was a bad year. Last year wasn't so bad, although we used a lot of salt last year because it was icy.
Exactly.
But we and came then, in just a dash under. What you do is you can't cut that by law. You're not allowed to cut that. And
correct.
That's a number that we've been.
What
time is that?
The
snow and ice.
The snow and ice budget.
The next
you budget $83,000 is the number that we have worked out over the years. You're not allowed by law to cut that.
You're not allowed by law to cut the salt budget.
No, you can't. You have to spend. No, not that one. The highway, the snow and ice.
You have to budget.
You're looking at the general highway.
This is a separate snow and ice
budget. But you are allowed to deficit spend. And as you can see, it depends on the winter, kind of winter we had. 2015 was horrible. We went way over. But we were actually under last year, even though we had a lot more.
Well, that's another, just up so the board's aware, I'm going to talk with Kevin about, you know, I'm not a big fan of just using all salt. I'd like to see them use sand for a number of reasons. And I understand, I've listened to Kevin explain about the cleaning and stuff like that, but I had a almost 2-hour conversation with the people at DEP exactly what you can do with the sand when you sweep, where you do have to sweep in the whole 9 yards and stuff like that. And I mean, a ton of salt is $100, a ton of sand is $6. It's huge. And in a lot of cases, the sand actually provides better traction. You know, it obviously does not melt the ice, but I've seen, and not just here, but the state does the same thing. I see a salt truck going down, and I see a snowplow going behind it. So, you know, where that salt goes is on the side of the road. I just, you know, I think the sand works better.
Well, I have to say that I think we're a little bit better. About Kevin is very conscientious about not putting down salt and then plowing the salt. But we can have that discussion. That's part of it, Kevin. Okay?
Sure.
Inspections department, do you want to just go over that?
Just find that here. Transfer station expense, well monitoring.
This is for.
What section is that in?
Now, there was a. Do you know why there was a. An $8,000 increase, $8,500 increase in that big salary?
Try and find this here.
What's that? What's the $8,500 increase?
In Dick Kalaszewski's salary.
What he's doing is he's breaking up his position into two, an inspector, for inspecting the building inspector and the health inspector. And I think you're going to see Dick changing his hours next year.
He is, yeah.
So that's what it is. It's a higher.
I think that's anticipating.
Exactly how that's going to work, I don't know.
Well, it's because Kyle, if Kyle takes more hours, he's getting paid more.
Okay.
So I think that was where the increase came in.
All right, well, where I was going with that is that I think.
Charlie Konecki, if he takes some of Dick's hours, he is also paid more than Dick.
And we also.
Both of those are.
We used to pay these people, the inspectors, out of, you know, the money that they raised. That money now goes into.
Yeah, they used to just keep them.
The general fund.
Right.
We actually balance our budget on.
Well, what I was going to say is I believe that, you know, by July, Dick's not going to be putting very many hours in there at all. You know, it's still maybe for the discussion that we need to have with him, you know, some months from now is if he remains on as a part-time building commissioner, and then we have Kyle Scott be the building inspector and see if we can't work it out that way.
Okay. Well, it will cost us, it will look like it costs us more because we will be paying more.
I'm going to meet with Dick and Kyle on Monday to talk about.
We can sort that out.
Going forward.
Okay.
All right. I just, I had a question on the building expense because if we might need more hours for.
Kyle?
Kyle, yeah.
Oh, we're definitely going to need more hours for Kyle, but
so then we'll have to.
It's only
you have to. You have
only
to
in the next
two people. For
let's talk. Let's talk more.
Oh, how come the this mosquito district that was dropped?
The what?
The mosquito district. Did you drop that?
That moved someplace else, and it's in there. $11,000 someplace.
Is that in the Board of Health expense?
Probably.
Okay.
We're going to pay. We're not going to spend no $11,000 on it.
Why? Yes,
we
are.
Because we can't have a district done yet. The district. We're going. The meeting tomorrow is just so that we can.
It got canceled.
Oh, it got canceled.
Because of the weather.
Oh.
Wednesday's meeting.
Oh, did you just get emails?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. That's just to allow us to move forward. And then we get a vote in September if we can actually form the district. So
I thought that's what we were doing last year. I mean, because last year we spent $11,000.
That was for testing.
And that was for VDCI, Victor Disease Control, to do our stuff.
You said it wasn't going to cost anymore.
I said it was going to cost less if we have the district. But it's we got the grant to form the district to start the planning process. But it's the process is at least another year away. Because you have, they're voting to allow us to go through the planning.
They're voting a lot.
The State Reclamation Board.
Yeah.
They allow us to vote the district, to allow us to form the district, and then we go in September, to, and they will allow us to, at that point, after we will go with our proposal to have the district.
So who are we paying the $11,000 to?
VDCI to do our work over the summer. We're actually getting free testing again through the state, so we should be able to do more testing with VDCI, you know, more collection and
so
know, samples.
So if we don't spend the $11,000 and we don't have these people do the trapping,
we're missing your data.
And but we still could, in the fall time, become part of this or be this district.
Well, we're hoping that's hoping the aim of the organization is to have us become a district in September, and then.
So then we're a district in September.
You're still going to have to pay to be in a district.
You still have to pay.
Yeah.
And so the next budget year, hopefully, we're hoping between $5,000 and $10,000 to be part of the district for basic joining. Now, ditch maintenance and all lava sliding and all that stuff is extra, and we have no idea what that's going to be at this point, but. I would say as a town, we are definitely interested in ditch maintenance because one of the advantages of going with the mosquito district is you are exempt from wetlands
regulations, so we could do ditch manage, a ditch maintenance. You, the town wouldn't clear out the ditch. The, whoever the employee of the mosquito district would come and say, this is part of mosquito control maintenance, and you get to clean out the ditch.
So the town would
like
then,
Bloody Brook.
So let's just say for Bloody Brook, if we wanted to clear that out, the town couldn't do it.
We can't, by law.
We would have to have this
mosquito district do it.
Mosquito district. And would we have any control over who did it and how much it cost, or?
Absolutely. That's why we're forming the district. It's contribution only, voluntary contribution only. We say to the district what we want. The way we're setting it up is not
a la carte kind of thing.
Yes, and it's not to the state's advantage at all. We're getting all the advantages, and normally the other districts pay off the cherry sheet, and they
it
just
comes right
pay
off of their tax sheet.
And they've been paying for years, and no one questions it. But we're setting it up as volunteer contributions, and we decide what we want. And we're using the UMass pool, labor pool for seasonal collections, which kids are going to be doing this collections, but they're going to be doing it for credit. So it's like, you know, pretty
and since I've never been involved, is it very difficult to get permission from DEP to clean out a brook?
It's impossible. Impossible. We've tried for years, and we've actually gotten in a little bit of trouble.
I also have the emergency management budget that you were anticipating from the emergency manager.
And we decided not to forward that.
To
right?
the finance committee?
Yeah.
That was my vote.
That was my vote.
Well.
You can't clean out ditches. Basically.
You don't have it
then. We've tried to do that. And that's why
the
this
emergency
is
emergency management budget. They're not forwarding
that.
We don't have it.
I
think they were.
It's the only part of it I think has any merit at all.
There's a lot of merit. There's a lot of merit. But we can take that off. Right.
Okay.
Okay.
Just waiting for salaries for the most.
Okay. So you want to take a vote? For what we've reviewed to pass to carry to the next step with the finance committee next week?
I guess now I'm
confused because I don't have a you mean am I approving any of these?
We're just
moving this forward to a discussion.
Yeah.
Right. We still haven't approved any of these.
You don't really have
okay.
to vote. I have in the notes what you've flagged and what you have concerns about and what you're happy with or
I already word that one. I made
no,
a motion.
We
don't. I don't think we have to.
We just
a sense of your
consensus.
Yeah. Okay.
That way, it's not so messy. How's that?
So you say.
So next week.
We need. Yeah. So Wendy, you're going to talk to Dick about Kyle and.
Yeah, Monday, he and I.
And also Charlie, right? Because Charlie is paid at a higher rate than Dick, so there might have to be some adjustment on that as well.
Trying to make a plan.
All right. There's no other questions?
No.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Chris. I think we're done.
Make a motion to adjourn.
Okay.
Second motion.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.